which is where she joins us from. Beverly, to you, you heard John Boehner say that. Basically, it's not going to happen. And you also just heard Donald Trump. I mean, he was talking about we're going to make it better. How is that any different than the repair and rebrand that Boehner's talking about?
Well, I do think that it takes time. You talked about March being a pivotal month. It no doubt will be. But if you even hear and talk to anyone here at CPAC, I think they would agree with me that there is a reason why John Boehner is no longer Speaker of the House. And that's because he didn't want to lead the Republican Party. Because here's what we do know is that people spoke across this country and said, we want Obamacare to be repealed. This is one of the reasons why Donald Trump won the presidency. It may take some time, but when you control three branches of government and can't push forward with repealing Obamacare, you aren't doing your job.
What does he do, Trump, when he's also facing the fact that now this new survey from Pew shows a record number of Americans approve of Obamacare?
So
to you, Beverly,
this,
sorry.
So when you see that there are people out there, yeah, that's okay. When you see that there are people out there that are concerned, I understand. And that's because in many ways, there is a narrative out there that people are somehow going to lose health insurance. And that's not the case. And that's because a really important part of this, which the House Republicans are talking about quite a bit, is making sure that there is replacement there. But we can't deny the fact that Obama in many ways has been a cancer. When you're even taking a look at small business owners, I am one myself, my premiums have tripled since Obamacare has been enacted. You saw American families, small business who's purchased their own insurance go up by 25% last year alone. So yes, there are going to be people that are concerned, but there are also many voices across this country that spoke in November who said we need to repeal this health care system.
Mayor, when you're looking at this and you're hearing John Boehner say that, and there are a lot of people, I mean, he's a Republican saying that.
Right.
You've got a lot of people who are just observing how difficult this is. They're watching the town halls. I mean, from your perspective, how do you see this? And I mean, Donald Trump could just repair and rebrand it, and it could go very well for him.
Well, a couple of things. First of all, the Republicans are getting their butts kicked at their own town hall meetings. So I think what we're really talking about now is retreat and rethink. They've been talking about this for about 7 years now and have still not been able to come up with anything that makes any sense. The one thing I will agree with Beverly on, they are now in charge of the White House, the House, and the Senate, and still can't reach agreement, which is what Speaker Boehner was talking about when he made those statements. People are worried about not having health care because half of them talk about repeal and replace. The other half talk about just repeal it completely. I think I heard Mr. Trump just say, you know, let it crash and burn. Well, you know, easy for you to say. You actually have health care, Mr. Trump. But those who are seeking treatment, pre-existing conditions, kids up to 26 years old, someone in the middle of cancer treatment or something like that, it's not a laughing matter for them. And so I think similar to what the speaker said, any big law, there are always going to be some parts that maybe need repair. You find out what happens, consequences, unintended. Go on. They are not going to wholesale repeal and replace because they can't figure out what to do, and they are getting an earful back home, and they're running scared now.
And speaking of an earful, I want you guys to listen to this because Obamacare is a big topic in these town halls, but so has President Trump's tax returns occasionally been. And this was a congressman in Florida confronted on this issue.
You have said that you're going to investigate the Russian allegations.
Do it!
Yes or no?
Absolutely, Donald Trump should release his tax returns.
All right, Mayor, that's not clearly what this crowd was expecting. I mean, does that kind of make the point that some of this is not, it really is about protesting and not always about discourse.
I mean, I haven't seen a pivot like that since Allen Iverson was playing basketball for the 76ers. I mean, he was getting hammered. And suddenly, he wants to start talking about Donald Trump's tax returns. I mean, it's hilarious. And again, these are their own town hall meetings. Their constituents are really upset about a bunch of different things. And these members of Congress really have to start trying to figure out, is this how I want to spend my time? Do I want to take this beating for the president, or do I want to pay attention to what my constituents want? Taking care of yourself is the first order of business in politics.
It was so fascinating. Here the